Welcome to Unleash the Awesome with Dave Gambrill. All of us have unique skills, talents, and abilities that aren't being used to their full potential. Our mission is to share the people, tools, apps, and other resources that will help you unleash your awesome on the world.
Yo, what's up? It's Dave. Welcome to another episode of Unleash the Awesome. Today, let's talk about it'll pull you under if you let it. What the heck am I talking about? Well, I'm actually talking about something called a rip current. Okay, if you've ever been to the beach, there's this very dangerous phenomenon that happens that's called a rip current. And what it is it's a little current that you could just be out there swimming in the ocean, having a good time with your family, and this little riptide or rip current comes along and it pulls you straight out to sea. All right, it just comes along. Sometimes you don't even know it's coming. If you're on the beach, sometimes you can see that it's starting to form, but if you're in the water, it's hard to know that it's happening. And then all of a sudden, you just start getting literally sucked out to sea. It just starts pulling you directly away from the beach right out to the ocean. And unfortunately, what a lot of people will try to do when that happens to them is they will fight it. They will try to swim directly against it. They will try to swim directly back to the shore. And that is oftentimes when people don't have a good outcome because they fight it. They try to swim against it. They get tired. Maybe they go under. Maybe they go under for good, which is obviously not a situation we want to have happen, right? So what do you do instead when you get caught in a rip current? Well, what you do is you look at the beach, right? You find a landmark on the beach and you say, okay, pretty much from where I am to that landmark on the beach, the rip current is here. Rip currents are usually pretty narrow. And then you float or swim parallel to the beach. So you see your landmark there and you just start trying to work your way down parallel to the beach, to the side. You get out of the side of the rip current. And then once you're out there, then you can just use the regular tide to just ride the waves back in because you'll probably be tired. It could be a tiring thing, right? But the whole idea is that you have to relax. It still may pull you out, keep pulling you out, but the one thing you do not want to do is fight it or swim against it because it will pull you under. And I'm using that analogy to explain what we have going on in the world right now, right? There's a lot of interesting things going on in the world, public health challenges, which are creating financial challenges and business challenges and all this stuff. And what I see a lot of people doing is swimming directly against the current, the riptide. They're trying to swim headfirst right back into it. And what I mean by that is they're posting crazy things on social media or they're screaming and yelling at the government and protesting, which don't get me wrong, I'm not against that. Go out and protest if you want. But I think while you're expending energy on all these other things, you're not going to have enough energy to do what you need to do, which is refocus so that you can take care of your family. You can take care of your business. You can take care of your neighbors. You can take care of your clients. You can take care of your customers, right? So if you would spend more energy and effort pivoting right now, seeing how you can help, what you can do, what you can make happen based on the current guidelines and recommendations, I think you're going to be in a better place than fighting it. Now, fighting it is a long-term strategy, and if you want to do that, great, but that's not really going to help you in the short term or even the midterm, right? You got to take some actions right now, immediately, today, right? So how do you rescue yourself, if you will, and then put yourself in a position where you can help other people? That's the second thing I want to share with you. In water rescue, one of the first things I'll tell you is don't become a victim yourself. So if you see somebody caught in a rip current or rip tide, the worst thing you can do is go run out there and then swim right into the rip tide with them. Now, that's why you see lifeguards that will go out there with a flotation device on a rope and they'll be outside of that rip tide or rip current and they'll swim out there and then they'll throw the flotation device and help pull the person out of it, right? So the first thing you gotta do is take care of yourself. The second thing is if you're gonna go rescue people, right, you gotta put yourself in a good place. It's also the analogy of being on an airplane when they say if the cabin becomes depressurized and the oxygen masks drop down, the first thing you gotta do is put an oxygen mask on your face first. You gotta take care of yourself first because you will have very bad mental challenges if you're in a depressurized cabin and you don't get oxygen quickly. So if you're trying to help somebody else, you could put yourself in a bad place. And then not only can you not help them, but you can't help yourself, right? So in a situation like this, you got to put yourself in a situation where you're going to help. What I mean by this is, again, I see people online jumping in conversations and stirring the pot and talking about conspiracy theories, which, okay, fine, if that's what we're going to do, I'm not going to argue any of those. I'm not going to expend energy on those because I am trying to reserve my own energy to do the things I need to for my family, my business, my clients, my friends, people listening to my podcast, things like that, right? And the last thing I'll talk about is, you know, Jim Rohn, who's one of my favorite personal development guys to listen to. By the way, his whole library, I think, is available on Audible right now, which is really great. One credit and you can get his huge library on Audible. I'll make sure I put the link in the show notes for you for that. But Jim Rohn used to talk about this idea of the same winds blow on all of us. It is up to us to determine the set of our sail, right? So all this stuff's going on. You can decide if you want to, like some people are doing, to take your 13-foot sunfish little sailboat and try to sail it right into an oncoming hurricane, which is probably not smart, but that's what I see a lot of people doing. Or you'd be like, whoa, we need to get the boat out of the water for a few minutes or a few days, let this thing pass, and then reassess and see what's going on, right? So my encouragement to you would be, how can you pivot right now? How can you take action right now? What are some short-term things you could do right now? Back in March, I did an episode called There is Opportunity in the Disruption. And I don't have it pulled up here what the episode number is, but I'll make sure that I put that in the show notes for you, right? And I talked about before this thing really started in earnest, like it's going on right now, there's going to be opportunities. There's things going on. So if you've been paying attention and you took action, then you're probably in a good spot. But if you're new to the podcast and you weren't paying attention and you haven't taken action, it's not too late. Right now would be a good time to reassess what you're doing. Are you swimming against the rip current, or are you figuring out how to navigate it, get out of it, and then reassess, right? Get on shore and then help yourself, help your family, help your business, help your clients, right? You're not going to do anybody any good if you're just wrapped up in mental gymnastics and fighting people on Facebook all day, right? That's not going to help you in your business. And so I want to do this podcast episode today to help you refocus, reframe, and stop swimming against the current because it will pull you under. All right, that's it for today's episode. Until next time, go unleash your awesome on the world. See ya.
Thanks for listening to Unleash the Awesome. Please be sure to subscribe, rate, and review wherever you listen to your podcasts. And please share us on your favorite social media platforms using hashtag UnleashAwesome.